Good morning. Welcome to Sycamore Creek Church in Potterville. My name's Kevin. I'm our worship leader. Really glad that you're joining us for worship today. Whenever you're watching this, we're just doing a 1 week series right now, leading up to Easter called Revive Your Invite. And we're going to talk about invitations to start things off. When's the last time you were invited to something? And I've received invitations over the last year, probably less than normal. Some, you know, people will text and say, hey, let's get together, some of that. But the last time I received an actual invitation in the mail, I think was in August, to a gala for National Writers Series in Traverse City, which was a really fun outdoor event last summer. It was great. But it was the last time that I was invited to something. I think I have a 50th anniversary party coming up that I just got to save the date in the mail. But yeah, there are not a lot of invitations lately. What about you? When's the last time that you were invited to an event? And let's sing a couple songs together.
Our Father, all-creating one, God Almighty, through your Holy Spirit, conceiving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior. I believe in God our Father, I believe in Christ the Son, I believe in the Holy Spirit, our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. Our judge and our defense, suffered and crucified, forgiveness is in you. Descended into darkness, you rose in glorious light, forever seated high. I believe in God our Father, I believe in Christ the Son, I believe in the Holy Spirit, our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, then we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in you. I believe you rose again. I believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe in you. I believe you rose again. I believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in the life eternal. I believe in the virgin birth. I believe in the saints' communion and in your holy church. I believe in the resurrection when Jesus comes again, for I believe in the name of Jesus, for for I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of Jesus. God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast meant, Thou forever. I see all I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and springtime. Sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in a manifold witness to Thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is Thy morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Sin and the peace that endureth, Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Grace and peace be with you. Hi, my name is Mark. I'm the pastor at Sycamore Creek Church in Potterville. I'm thrilled you've joined us today for our online worship service. We're doing just a one-part, one message. It's called Revive Your Invite, where we're helping us all together prepare for Easter next week. And as we prepare for Easter, we remember that today is Palm Sunday. Today is the day that Jesus had this triumphal entry into the Jerusalem where people cried out, Hosanna, Hosanna. People were so excited about Jesus and his coming into Jerusalem, not realizing the week that would be ahead of him. But we have all kinds of things that Sycamore Creek is doing in the upcoming week to help you remember that final week of Jesus' life and to help us celebrate the resurrection. I hope that you will be a part of those different things that we are doing to celebrate and remember that week. At this time in the worship service, I'm going to ask you to get a candle. I have my candle here in Potterville. Get a candle at your home, wherever you are, and light that candle as an act of worship. And remember that God is present with you as you worship. I'm going to light my candle. You light yours at home. Today, may we look to the light of that candle as a reminder of Jesus' presence with us. God is with us today as we celebrate Palm Sunday. And as we look today to Jesus as the center of our worship, I invite you to pray with me. Will you pray with me? God, we thank you today for Jesus and for the life that he lived. We thank you for the recognition that we have that Jesus is the true king. Maybe not the king that we would expect, maybe not a political king who is going to lead an earthly government, but the king who offers us true life in the true kingdom of God. I pray, God, that we would look today to you and to our true King Jesus, and that our worship would center on Jesus, and that we might, through our worship today, prepare ourselves for this upcoming week and for our celebration of Easter and the resurrection of your son, Jesus. It is in his name that we pray. Amen. I want to ask you to continue praying with me as we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Please join me in that prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Now, as I mentioned today, we are going to be talking about reviving your invite. Revive is our theme this year for Easter, and you'll hear more about that in the message today, which is given by our lead pastor of Sycamore Creek, Tom Arthur. But first, here is our host for this morning.
Welcome to Sycamore Creek Church in Potterville. We're glad that you've joined us for worship. My name is Danielle, and I am the director of our children's ministry at Sycamore Creek Church in Potterville. I'm also our host for today, and I'm glad that you've joined us for worship. Please take a moment and fill out a connection card at sycamorecreekchurch.org/connection. We'll refer to that connection card again later in the worship service. Connect with us for the first time, and we'll send you a free book. Another great way to connect is by chatting and commenting on the worship service. We would love to interact with you. If today's worship is helpful for you, please take a moment to share it with your friends on social media. You can share the worship service and use our hashtag SCCPotterville. Today's message begins with this.
I'm up.
It's him again.
Him who?
Him.
And all my nervousness, it returns. What I want to say, inside it burns. I just had a message.
Fine. We'll go to church with you.
We don't care what you wear. Our pastor is funny. We won't ask for money.
Who even uses a boombox anymore?
Yeah, I'll say anything to get us to go to church.
Today we're talking about inviting people to church, to Easter. That's like next week, friends. We want to revive your invite. Now here's what we're going to talk about today. What we're inviting to, why we're inviting, who we're inviting, and how we're inviting. I mean, it's been hard to invite anybody to anything over the last 2 years. There's such a wide variety of people's comfort levels with being in groups, being indoors, being outdoors. I mean, at this point, I've had 2 shots. I've been boosted. I've had COVID. So I'm pretty much comfortable anywhere I go. But I'm not representative of every single person. The experts tell us that we're moving from a pandemic to an endemic and that we're just having to learn to live with this thing for, who knows, the foreseeable future. But as we go into this endemic stage of COVID, there's a dynamic spectrum of caution. I mean, some people are okay doing inside events. Some people want to do outside events only. Some people want to wear a mask indoors, and some people are ready for masks to be a thing of the past. It's like the whole rhythm of our lives has been put in a blender and it's just gotten destroyed.
Wow!
So nobody knows what they're doing or when they're doing it or whether they want to do it together or not. So here's a question for you. Turn to somebody next to you if you're in the room, or if you're online, comment in the chat section. What's been your experience over these last 2 years, the positive and the negative, of inviting people to, well, really anything? What we're going to start talking about today is what exactly you're inviting to. I mean, there's at best like a misperception of what church is, and at worst, a real awareness of some of the abuses of church out there. I think about this one guy that I came across on YouTube who puts stuff to kind of heavy metal music. And here he is, he's sitting at the kitchen table watching this church TV preacher with his kid playing Duplos, and he starts thinking about, what if this was, well, a heavy metal concert? And here's what happens.
I execute judgment on you, COVID-19. Oh. I execute judgment on you, Satan. You destroyer, you killer, you get out, you break your power, you get off this nation. I demand judgment on you.
So sometimes our first problem It's just helping people know that that is not what church is like. Well, except maybe the heavy metal part. COVID temps have gone high, but what that's done to our invitational temperature is it's dropped it into a polar plunge. Listen, I get it. It's been hard. It's been hard for me to invite, but we got to get our temperature back up. We've got to revive our invite. Now, here's the good news. You attend a church that offers all kinds of options to invite people to. I mean, we got outdoor events, we got indoor events, masks are optional, we got online stuff. We got a party in Potterville, we got a party in South Lansing. I mean, let's take a look at each of our campuses and what they're doing. Here's what Potterville looks like. Starting on Wednesday night, we've got a Living Last Supper at 7 p.m. And then on Thursday, we're going to serve the community with a free car wash at Mr. Clean in Potterville. Come serve your community from 5 to 7 p.m. Easter egg hunt on Saturday at Potterville Park at 10 a.m. I mean, you can't do a better Easter egg hunt than what we're doing in Potterville with the community involved. A little later on Saturday evening at 2 p.m. is our Holy Saturday Spirit Service, free tacos at Sanctuary Spirits. I mean, who doesn't want free tacos? On Sunday morning, we've got a community Easter sunrise service at 7 a.m. at Lake Alliance Park, and pets are welcome. And then we got our normal Easter services on Sunday, 9 a.m. online and 10:30 in person. That's the party at Potterville, friends. And it doesn't matter whether you live in Potterville or not. You can go to any of that kind of stuff, and you can invite people to it. But here's the party at South Lansing. On Friday night, April 15th, we got Good Friday in a garage, poetry slam, and free barbecue at my house, the Parsonage in Holt. I mean, who doesn't want free barbecue in the driveway? Invite your friends just for the free food. On Saturday morning, we've got a neighborhood Easter egg hunt with Scott Woods at 11 a.m. On Easter morning, we've got our community Easter sunrise service in Mount Hope Cemetery at 7 a.m. And pets are welcome. And then, of course, our Sunday morning Easter services at South Lansing, 10:30, both in person and online, followed by free barbecue on the patio, along with a photo booth and face painting and all kinds of fun stuff out there. We got a serious set of options to invite people to all kinds of parties at both of our campuses. Now, I keep talking about these things like they're parties, and you're probably wondering, what's a party got to do with Easter? Well, Jesus tells a story about being invited to a party. Yes, the kingdom of heaven is gonna be like a party.
You gotta fight for your right to party.
Hearing this, a man sitting at the table with Jesus exclaimed, "What a blessing it will be to attend a banquet in the kingdom of God." A banquet of blessing, a party of profit, a celebration of credit, a festivity of favor, a revelry of resources, a bash of benefits, and a gala of gain. I mean, this is the party that we're going to be throwing at Easter at Potterville and the party that we're throwing at Easter at South Lansing. And all of this is not even to get to the whole point of why we're throwing the party. That's what I want to talk about now. Why we're inviting. What exactly does Easter mean?
The word Easter literally refers to the time of year in the spring when the days become longer than the nights. But for the person who knows Jesus Christ, Easter means a lot more than that. It means that even though Jesus died, salvation didn't. Even though Jesus was buried, hope wasn't. Because Jesus is alive. Easter means there is forgiveness for my failures, grace for my guilt, and mercy for my misery. Easter means that the pain and the silence of living in a Saturday world isn't purposeless and it isn't permanent. Easter means that I can't out-sin the grace of God and I can't outrun the reach of God. It means that Jesus is King, light overcomes darkness, justice will win, and brokenness will be broken. Easter means that the scars on the hands of Jesus are telling a story of victory, not defeat, and the same is true for me. It means that I am not alone, not ashamed, not forgotten, and not forsaken. It means that the rain and the storms and the wind and the waves of this world will not have the last word, because my future is a resurrected body with a resurrected Jesus on a resurrected earth. Easter means that I can join with a choir of saints and angels singing, "Oh death, where is your victory? Oh grave, where is your sting? Oh hell, where is your song?" Easter means that as far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed my transgressions from me. And as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for me. Easter means that even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil because you are with me.
In the shadow of COVID, I think Easter means to be revived, to restore to consciousness or life. I mean, literally, we're talking about the resurrection here, but if we're honest, a lot of us need a resurrection spiritually, physically, emotionally, relationally. We need to be revived to consciousness. Revive also means to restore from a depressed, inactive, or unused state, to bring back. It's time to regain, to revive what has been lost to depression or inactivity or disuse, and to renew in the mind or memory. We're talking about being renewed, being revived this Easter. What would you say is the point of Easter or the meaning of Easter for you and for those around you? Turn to somebody you're sitting next to, or if you're online in the chat section, let us know the answer to that question. Let's talk about this. Talking about reviving your invite, and so far we've talked about what we're inviting to, and then we talked about why we're inviting, and now we're going to talk about who you're going to invite. Jesus continues telling this story about an invitation to a party, saying, "A man prepared a great feast and sent out many invitations, and when the banquet was ready, he sent his servant to tell the guests, 'Come, the banquet is ready.'" I mean, this host of the party has what all of us have. It's got like a first list of invites. It's the expected people, the friends and family list. When you think about who you'd invite to Easter, your first list could easily just be the expected people, like the people who already belong to the church, but maybe you haven't seen them in a long time. That's like the low-hanging fruit when it comes to inviting people. Tomorrow, Monday, April 11th, we're going to gather at South Lansing, and we're going to call everybody at our South Lansing campus. It's called the Easter Phone Challenge. I mean, literally, we're going to call everybody, and you can sign up on your connection card. Now, if you're at the Potterville campus, there's no organized event that we're going to do to call everybody, but there's no reason why you can't pick up your phone and just call somebody and invite them who you haven't seen in the last year or two. Now, Jesus continues this story about being invited to a party, saying, "But they all began making excuses. One said, 'I've just bought a field and must inspect it. Please excuse me.' And another said, 'I've just bought 5 pairs of oxen and I want to try them out. Please excuse me.' And another said, 'I just got married, so I can't come.'" In this parable, there's excuses about business, about finances, about relationships, but really, all of these excuses just belie a certain set of priorities, and Jesus is kind of unmasking those priorities. Now, when you invite people to church, you're going to hear excuses. I mean, that's just how people are. Some people are going to say, you know what, I'm not ready to be back in person in a big group of people. Well, that's okay. We've got something online. Or I'm just not ready to be inside with people. You know what? That's all right. We got events that are outside. Sunday morning is my only day to sleep in. You know what? We got events at night. I just don't agree with the beliefs of the Christian church. Well, that's okay, because we're a curious church. Your questions are welcome, and you don't have to agree with us to belong. I'm just not that interested. I don't care. I mean, church is so boring. You've never been to a church that does things creatively. I just don't feel welcome at church. You know, I've been hurt by the church in the past. We get that. A lot of people at Sycamore Creek have been hurt by the church in the past too, but we're a church that's compassionate. We're not going to nail this every time, but we're going to do our best to show you the compassion of God, no matter who you are or where you've been or what you've done or where we meet you. All of these excuses only end up losing out on the joy of the celebration, the banquet of blessing, the party of profit, the celebration of credit, the festivity of favor, the revelry of resources, the bash of benefits, or the gala of gain. So who's on your first list of invites to Easter? It's time to revive our invite. Now, if the people on your first list don't accept your invitation, don't worry. God's got even more invites coming. Back to the story that Jesus is telling of being invited to a party. The servant returned and told his master what they had said. His master was furious and said, "Go quickly into the streets and alleys of the town and invite the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame." The second invitation list is an invitation list that goes out to the town, the alleys, the byways. I mean, like the diversity of the invitation expands to those that you wouldn't expect to be invited to the party, the banquet. The poor, the marginalized, and people are more likely to accept invitation when they find themselves in a place of tension, transition, or trouble. There's an abundance of tension, transition, and trouble right now. I mean, there's trouble relationally. Our families are falling apart. Our marriages are falling apart. There's a tension financially. Like, we're struggling just to pay the bills. There's a tension vocationally. I mean, this whole thing about the great resignation, people changing jobs. There's so much tension, transition, and trouble right now that people are open to being invited in a way that maybe they never have been. I mean, again, these are people who never thought they'd be invited to the party, but they show up and they receive the benefits of the banquet. Joy. The banquet of blessing, the party of profit, the celebration of credit, the festivity of favor, the revelry of resources, the bash of benefits, and the gala of gain. There are some groups of people that have not traditionally felt welcome to church. The poor and the homeless, those without resources, those in the LGBTQ community, and in many cases, the church has kept women from full participation in the church. These are the sort of invites that the story is talking about, and maybe they're invites that you want to make who are on your second list of reviving your invite. Who is on your second list of Easter invites? But if nobody accepts who's on your second list, don't worry, God has more invites. Jesus continues the story. After the servant had done this, he reported, "There is still room for more." So his master said, "Go out into the country lanes and behind the hedges and urge anyone you find to come so that the house will be full. For none of those I first invited will get even the smallest taste of my banquet." This third invitation list is an invitation list that goes out into the country, out into the highways and the byways. We're talking about a great diversity of people, people who do things differently. We have different customs and cultures. In fact, Jesus is probably originally talking about ethnic Gentiles versus ethnic Jews. The party has been opened up to all kinds of people, racially and ethnically. Now, here at South Lansing, we've been doing our best to begin to use a wide expression of different cultures and ethnicities in our worship. We've got gospel, and we've got rap and hip hop and poets and all kinds of expressions here. And at our Potterville campus, we're also looking for ways that we can put diverse voices on the stage in front of us and engage them and listen to them. When you show up, you're going to receive the diverse benefits of the party, the banquet, the diverse joy, the banquet of blessing, the party of profit, the celebration of credit, the festivity of favor, the revelry of resources, and the bash of benefits, the gala of gain.
So who is on your third list of Easter invites? Revive your invite. So here's a chat question for you. Turn to the person next to you or comment in the comment section. Who are the three people or the three categories of people that you could invite to Easter? Let's talk about that. So far, we've talked about what we're inviting to, why we're inviting, and who we're inviting. Let's talk about how we're inviting. Here's what I want to do. I want to give you three tips for how to revive your invite. And the first one is pray. You've written down three names or three categories of people, and take some time to pray. Pray that God would open the door naturally to invite them. I remember one time one of my neighbors was on my invite list, and I was praying for God to open the door to invite him. And she just had a baby, so I brought some food down. And as I was delivering the food to them, she said, "You know what, I've seen on Facebook this dad's group that you've got." And boom, there was the natural invite to invite her husband to be part of our dad's group. The second tip is to invite, pick up, and bring. I know that's three all in two, but bear with me here, okay? Once you've made the invite, actually go pick them up. Say, "Hey, I'll come by your house and you want to drive?" And then bring them into the room. Or another way to think about this is say, "When you get here, text me or call me and I'll come meet you out in the parking lot." Do you know how awkward it is to walk into a big room of people that you don't know anybody? I mean, help overcome that awkwardness by inviting, picking up, and bringing the people that are coming to church with you on Easter. The third tip is to invest and invite. This has to be a lifestyle of investing in the people around you. I mean, your first step towards inviting somebody on this list might not be actually inviting them. It might just be investing time in them, more time in them. I mean, genuinely being interested and curious about them, genuinely showing them compassion. And so your invite may start with simply inviting them to get together for coffee or over to your house for a meal or asking if there's anything that they need help with at their house and going and participating and helping them. Our lifestyle as Christians should be one of investing in the people around us. So invest and invite. This Easter season, we're reviving our invite. Reviving my invite, reviving your invite, reviving all of our invites together. And you are invited to invite.
Many of us hear a voice that pulls on our hearts. It's a good voice that speaks to us about the people in our lives. And it's inviting us to invite them to our church. but something prevents us from acting on it. Maybe it's the fear of what they might think. Maybe it's a feeling that we're in some way disqualified. Maybe we feel like we don't have all the answers yet, or that we don't want to put our friends on the spot. But Easter's just around the corner, and that changes the game. It's unique, because most people already want to go to church on Easter. They just need to be invited. So what might happen if you asked God, who? That's it. God, who should I invite? He will answer that prayer, because he's anxious to answer that prayer. We only need ears to hear. And maybe that voice has actually been his voice all along.
Again.
Hey man, can I ask you something?
Sure, what's up?
I have a couple of quick announcements for us. The first announcement is that as part of our worship today, we would love to help you get connected to Sycamore Creek. We'd love to help you take next steps that help you to grow in your faith. You can do that by filling out a digital connection card at sycamorecreekchurch.org/connection, or you can use the QR code that's there on the screen and it'll take you right to that link. If you fill out that digital connection card for the first time, well, we have a free book we'd like to send you. It's a book by Max Lucado called You'll Get Through This. We'll send that right from Amazon directly to your house. We have some exciting things that are coming up this week for Easter. Just a reminder of all the things that you can revive your invite around. We start this Wednesday with The Living Last Supper. It's an amazing production. We started rehearsing for it this Sunday, and it's really gonna be good. I'm excited about it. On Thursday night, we are going over to Mr. Clean Car Wash here in Potterville, and for 3 hours, we're gonna give away free car washes to people in our community. And then on Saturday, we have two things. We have our East Community Easter Egg Hunt in the morning at 10 a.m., and then we have our Sanctuary Spirits Worship Service at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. And then Sunday morning, we've got lots of great options. Again, on Sunday, Easter Sunday, we start with a sunrise service at Lake Alliance at 7 a.m. We continue to worship with our 9 a.m. online worship and conclude with a 10:30 a.m. in-person worship service. That's going to be a great Easter week. I can't wait for you to join us at one of those celebrations. And coming out of Easter, we have some great things that are coming up as well later this month. At the end of the month, on April 30th, we'll have a mobile food pantry that we're involved with through the Greater Lansing Food Bank. We bring in a whole semi-truck of food here to Potterville and distributing it to anyone in our area who needs food. That's gonna be in the morning on Saturday, April 30th, from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. If you wanna receive food, you're welcome to receive food. If you wanna be a part of distributing that food, let me know, and we'd love to help you to be a part of volunteering in that event. Finally, on April 30th in the afternoon, we're gonna have a partnership class. If you're interested in becoming a partner of Sycamore Creek Church, you wanna partner with us in our mission, you wanna learn more about what that means, come join me for that class here in Potterville from 1 to 4 in the afternoon on April 30. I wanna thank you for your giving to support the mission of Sycamore Creek. Giving is such an important part of how we grow in our faith and how we live out our faith. Now, giving changes you, and it supports the church. It supports the work of Jesus that we as a church do. Thank you for being a part of that. Now, one of the ways that Sycamore Creek Church is accomplishing our mission is that we've got our nursery back open again for in-person worship. I love this. It's a great option for parents to come and be able to drop their kids off and to be able to worship without the distraction of a little one. That's a great thing. And the parents who use that service, thank you for supporting our church so that we can give that place for our kids to have fun and to be with adults who engage them and who care about them, freeing up parents to focus on being able to worship together with other adults. Thank you for your giving to support the mission of Sycamore Creek, where we are accomplishing that through all age groups, including among our littlest ones through the nursery. Here is Kevin with our final song.
My Jesus.
Jesus, I love thee. I know thou art mine. For thee, all the follies of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior art thou. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. I love thee because thou hast first loved me and purchased my pardon on Calvary's tree. I love thee for wearing the thorns on thy brow. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. I love thee in life, I will love thee in death, and praise thee as long as thou lendeth me breath. And say when the death dew lies cold on my brow, if ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. In mansions of glory and endless delight, I'll ever adore thee in heaven so bright. I'll sing with the glittering crown on my brow. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now.
Go in peace. Have a great week. I hope to see you again soon.